11 p.m. on a Saturday. Let's do this. In the last video, we went over how to set up a YouTube studio for $0 to $61. We also went over some tips and tricks on how to use that gear and make some small upgrades if you wanted to. If you haven't checked out that video, open it up in another tab and go to it after this video is completed. Here we're gonna level up that kit and find the best YouTube setup for under $500. And some of these upgrades may come as a surprise to you. Jumping straight into the camera, believe it or not, we're going to use the same camera we used in the last video, and that is our phone's camera. If we're using our phone, we want to use that Filmic Pro app. And if you are using your phone and it will be a little farther away, using a little cheap tripod that you can find on Amazon and ratchet your phone into will really get us really far. At this price point, if we were going to buy a camera, it would eat up our entire budget. So be sure to check out my previous video for those in-camera settings and best practices to get the best results out of your phone's camera. When it comes to lighting, this is the first big upgrade we're gonna make. Good lighting is something I wish I learned about a lot earlier, as a camera is only as good as the light you put in front of it. High quality light will really allow your camera to capture great images. There's a wide range of lights to choose from, but my favorite affordable light and the one I started with is the Godox SL60W. This light is a great value for starting YouTube or even just smaller productions. It isn't perfect, but for $135, you'll be hard-pressed to find a better light at this price point. One thing to be aware of is that you can hear the fan noise in this light, so be sure to put your microphones far enough away from your light so that the noise isn't picked up by your microphones. Another drawback of this light is the total output. If you're using this light outside, it will be very difficult to overpower the bright sun, but it produces daylight balanced light, so it is good to use as a fill light if you are outside on a cloudy day even. But if you're inside, it is a fantastic key light. To shape the light, we're going to use a softbox, and I have a few different softboxes to choose from based on what look and price range you're going for. The first softbox we're gonna look at is the Glow EasyLock 28-inch Bowens Mount Deep Parabolic Softbox. This softbox costs about $70 and will allow us to take our hard light coming from our SL60W and turn it into a larger, soft light source that we can control and diffuse and even direct with the included grid. The Glow softboxes aren't that durable, but they can get the job done if you are very careful with them. If you're looking for something a little more high quality, Lofos sent me a softbox to try out, and it does seem to be of higher quality than the Glow softbox that I purchased. The Glow softbox is really for a budget price point, but if you find yourself using a softbox for more productions or moving the lights around and not just putting your light in one spot and never touching it again, I would say check out the Lofos softbox. It is about $50 more expensive than the same size Glow softbox, but the softbox material itself and the rods that go into the center Bowens mount ring are all higher quality than the Glow. I took this around on a couple of different shoots, and I like the fact that you have to click each of the rods up to use them. The Glow is really fast to put together because it only has one locking mechanism in the center. But that being said, if one of your rods gets off center, the material is so thin that one of the rods can poke through that material. That's how I broke my first Glow softbox, but you have to be really careful with those ones. With the Lofos, the design is just different and all of the rods individually click on their own to form the softbox. That's a really convoluted thing about a softbox, but that's one that I ran into, and I had to buy two Glow softboxes when I probably could have just bought one of these single locking arm softboxes. Another modifier you might find helpful is the lantern with the skirt. Lofos sent me this to try out a while ago, and I've been using it as a big soft light source when I just need a lot of light within the area. This mounts directly onto the SL60W or any Bowens mount light, and it throws a ton of soft light evenly around the room. The best part is you can use the included skirt to control light from coming off the lantern. Be careful if you're ordering this lantern though, because there are multiple versions and some of them aren't including the skirt. I'd recommend using this with sandbags and a C-stand to boom it over your subject. That will drive up the overall price, but if the high key look is something you're going for, a lantern is definitely something you want to check out. If you're not wanting the lantern and you just want to use a softbox, You can get a lot of bang for your buck by not buying a C stand and just getting a very high quality light stand. I realize spending money on a light stand isn't the most exciting thing, but this is a stand you'll have forever, and there is a danger to buying cheap light stands for bigger lights. Cheap light stands tend to creep down over time and, in the worst case scenarios, fall over. Lights falling over damage your equipment and whatever is underneath it. Most oftentimes it's people. To avoid this, we're going to buy an impact air cushioned light stand. This is heavy duty enough to support the light reliably while also not breaking the bank, coming in at about $50. The light is large, so I would recommend using sandbags between the legs to keep them stable and from falling over. Side note, I'm a big fan of using large rocks or pavers in plastic bags in my sandbags. Speaking from experience, using sand or tiny rocks can be a nightmare if the bag rips on set or while you're transporting them. I touched on a few ways on how to control light on our $0 YouTube set video, and in that video we're using black poster board and white poster board to bounce and absorb light. But if you're going to invest in lighting, I can't leave out investing in a reflector. I take this reflector with me everywhere I go, and it's really easy to reflect, absorb, or diffuse light. It's pretty affordable at $20 to $30, and it can be a great complement to a single light setup since you can use this as a fill light. You can use this to bounce light back onto yourself, and the best part about this is that the light is the exact same color temperature as your light since we're just bouncing the light back onto ourselves. If you'd like to learn more about bouncing and reflecting light with a reflector, check out my 3-point lighting system. I will leave a link to that in the description below and at the end of the video. To me, audio is one of the most important parts of making videos, so knowing that we have a nice external microphone that we can work with any camera that we purchase in the future is really important here. I went with the Deity D3 Pro, and this microphone can plug directly into a smartphone, DSLR, mirrorless camera, or any 3.5mm or XLR input if you're using the adapter. I reached out to Deity to see if they would send me a mic to review, and I've been using my Rode VideoMic Pro for the last few years, but since this video is focused on the best bang for your buck, the Deity D3 Pro and the Deity D3 are the best value options out there on the market right now. The D3 is a great budget option if you want to use your microphone on your camera, but I went with the D3 Pro for its internal battery and the two different low-cut filters for noisy locations. The D3 Pro can also be used with the DXLR and the Rycote grip to mount to a XLR boom pole for simple booming so you can get the mic as close to the subject as you possibly can. That's how we'll be using the microphone, but with the simple 3.5mm extension cable. It's boomed out to get the mic as close as possible to me to get the cleanest audio. The closer the microphone, the cleaner the audio will be. To do this, we'll use a pretty affordable Amazon Basics mic stand to hold onto our microphone and cable. I'm using my iPhone, so I'll also have to use the Lightning to 3.5mm adapter as well. A nice feature of the D3s is that the mic detects the connection that your camera needs, so you don't have to bring any TRS or TRRS adapters with you. It just does it automatically when you plug your camera in. Booming our microphone over the subject and plugging it directly into our camera will also bake that audio directly into our footage, so we don't have to sync anything in post-production. It's amazing how upgrading your audio and your lighting can make such a big difference to your videos. And the best part about upgrading this is that if we choose to upgrade our camera in the future, all of our lighting and audio equipment will make our new camera really stand out. In the next video, I'm going to be upgrading this kit even farther, and I think you know what that next upgrade is, so be sure to subscribe and get notified when I post my videos so you can be the first to see that video. If you haven't seen my $0 to $61 YouTube studio video, even if you already have all of this gear, I would say check that video out next. That has a lot of tips and tricks and little nuggets of information in it that can even help this setup be a little bit better. I'll leave a link to that right here, as well as that video about my 3-point lighting setup that you can learn a little bit more about this reflector in. And I just want to say thank you guys for sticking around to the end, and I'll see you in the next video.